passkeys, and hardware keys. Yeah, I was wrong. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. There is no shortage of confusion around passkeys. I recently updated my article and video, What is a Passkey?, to try and further clarify what they are and how they work. Originally, I got one aspect of passkeys wrong, the confusion between passkeys and hardware keys, like the Yubico YubiKey. I thought they were completely unrelated. Not necessarily so. Okay, passkeys on your device. The article and video, What is a Passkey?, has a more complete overview, but the issue is relevant to what we'll discuss here. A passkey is a cryptographic secret, a blob of data, stored securely on your device. When you need to use that key, say to authenticate with a website when signing in, you'll likely be asked to authorize the device by entering a PIN, providing your face or fingerprint, or something else specifically to that device, to be able to fetch and use that secret key. For example, when you sign into a site using passkeys, on Windows, you might need to provide your Windows Hello PIN. On your phone, you might need to unlock it with your fingerprint, even if it's already unlocked. The key concept here is that your secret key is stored by your device securely, and you need to authenticate with the device to allow the device to access the key to use it. To date, we've talked about hardware keys, again, like the YubiKey, only in the context of two-factor authentication, their original and perhaps most common use. When you set up two-factor using a hardware key, you establish a cryptographic relationship between that key and the account you're setting it up with. The hardware key contains a pre-programmed, unique cryptographic key. Once set up, that, along with some magical math and synchronization, means that that key and only that key will be recognized as your authorized second factor. Typically, when you sign in for the first time on a new device, you'll enter your username and password and then be prompted to prove that you have the hardware key by inserting it into a USB port. Its cryptographic code is then confirmed to be correct, and the second factor is confirmed. That's one use of hardware keys. Turns out, there's another that I was unaware of. Hardware keys, some but not all, can be used as passkeys as well. As I mentioned, a passkey is a secret key that is stored somewhere secure, typically on your machine. It turns out that it can also be stored, or perhaps instead be stored, on a FIDO2 certified hardware key. FIDO2 certified is just a fancy way to say that the device has the functionality required to do this. Not all hardware keys are FIDO2 certified. Those that are not can only be used as 2FA keys. Those that are, however, can be used as both 2FA keys and as passkeys. Hardware keys that can act as passkeys typically have limited storage. Per Yubico, currently YubiKeys can store a maximum of 25 passkeys. This applies to their Series 5 FIDO2 certified keys. The advantage of using a hardware key as your passkey is that you can use your key anywhere to sign into the accounts associated with it. It's considered the most secure form of passkey storage. It's also the most inconvenient because, unlike other passkey storage techniques, the key, this thing, must be physically present. You have to have it in your hand in order to be able to use it. I'm not going to dive into the process in detail for setting up hardware keys as passkeys because, honestly, hardware keys are overkill for most of us, and the process can be confusing. I also expect, or rather, I hope, that the setup process will be streamlined at some point to make it easier and clearer. But, as just one example, after asking Google to add a passkey to my account, I'm faced with this dialogue. Now, create a passkey, which seems like the obvious thing to click on, will create a passkey on Windows that is stored in Windows, in secured credential storage, in your TPM. Any hardware key will be ignored. No, if you want to, for example, use the YubiKey, I need to instead choose Use Another Device. This will then bring up dialogues relating to inserting and setting up my particular YubiKey as a passkey. Now, the most popular hardware keys are made by Yubico. That's what I've got. I have a couple of these, actually. They have a nifty app you can run in Windows to examine and manage your YubiKey, the Yubico Authenticator. Here's an example. I have my FIDO2 compliant YubiKey inserted. You can see that it currently has two passkeys, one for each of two different Gmail accounts. Even though the keys are listed and you can view some data about them, there is no way to export or view the actual secret key. Note also the notification, 2 of 25 passkeys used. So if I remove this YubiKey, which apparently I just did, and insert my older non-FIDO2 compliant key, the passkeys are nowhere to be seen. Naturally, it's important to protect your hardware key from loss and theft, but neither is quite the disaster you might think it would be. Theft, for example. Well, the thief would need to know everything else required to sign into your account and know what account the passkey even applies to. When used as a passkey, there's typically a PIN you set up that the thief would need to know. In addition, if a thief attempts to sign in on a machine you've never used, they'll likely have to provide a second factor. If not, if you, for example, can sign in on a different machine using only the security key and its PIN, well, yeah, I strongly recommend you enable two-factor authentication. Loss. What happens if you lose your hardware key? There's always another way in. This is just exactly the same as losing your passkey, say, on your phone. It might be less convenient or more time-consuming to sign in, but you can typically sign in using an email code, a texted code, confirmation on another device that's already logged in, or something else. Once you're in, you can then visit the security settings for that account and disable the passkey that you've lost. Now, some people recommend always using hardware keys in pairs. Always set up two and store one in a safe place in case you lose the first one. This feels like overkill to me unless you're in a highly secure environment where passkeys truly are the only way in. Bottom line, hardware keys, yeah, they're overkill for most of us. I personally find them fascinating, and while I have them set up, it's mostly for example purposes, and I use the passkeys stored in my 1Password database instead. If you're considering using a hardware key for two-factor authentication and or passkeys, just make sure it's get one that is FIDO2 compliant, so you'll know you can use it for either or both when you need to. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/181120. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.